Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise the Lord, everyone. God is a good God. He is worthy to be praised. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, His name is worthy. We are here in the house of the Lord to do nothing else but to usher in His presence and just to give God glory that is due unto His name. Hallelujah. Shall we all stand? Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel His mighty power and His grace. I can feel the brush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. Oh, surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel His mighty power and His grace. Hallelujah. Bless God. Who is like you, Lord, in all the earth? Matchless love and beauty, endless worth. Nothing in the world can satisfy. Jesus, you're the cup that won't run dry. Your presence is heaven to me. Nothing in this world will satisfy. Jesus, you're the cup, you're the cup that won't run dry. Your presence is heaven to me. Redeemer of my past and present wrong, Lord of my future days to come. Your presence is heaven to me. Oh, Jesus.
your presence is heaven to me. Oh Jesus, your presence is heaven to me. Hallelujah. Who loves the presence of the Lord? Hallelujah. We are going to serve the Lord with gladness. We are going to serve Him with a willing heart. Hallelujah. Serve the Lord with gladness. Serve Him with a willing heart. Serve Him when all Satan tries to tear your head apart. Serve Him when the going gets rough. Serve Him when the times are hard. As for me and my house, we'll always serve the Lord. Oh, serve the Lord with gladness. Serve Him with a willing heart. Serve Him when all Satan tries to tear your whole apart. Serve Him when the going gets rough. Serve Him when the times are hard. And for me and my house, we'll always serve the Lord. Serve the Lord with gladness. Serve Him with a willing heart. Serve Him when all Satan tries to tear your world apart. Serve Him when the going gets rough. Serve Him when the times are hard. And for me and my house, we'll always serve the Lord. Serve the Lord with gladness. Serve Him with a willing heart. Serve Him when all Satan tries to tear your world apart. Serve Him when the going gets rough. Serve Him with a heart of heart. And for me and my house, we'll always serve the Lord. Serve the Lord with gladness. Serve Him with a willing heart. Serve Him when all Satan tries to tear your world apart. Serve Him when the going gets rough. Serve Him when the times are hard. And for me and my house, we'll always serve the Lord. Serve the Lord with gladness. Serve Him with a willing heart. Serve Him when all Satan tries to tear your world apart. Serve Him when the going gets rough. Serve Him when the times are hard. And for me and my house, we'll always serve the Lord. Serve the Lord with gladness. Serve the Lord with gladness. Serve Him with a willing heart. Serve Him when
Bless the name of the Lord. I want you to remain standing. Amen. Tonight, I just want to take this opportunity to greet our diocesan bishop, to our vice chairman, praise God, to all of our suffragan bishops, our pastors, district elders, and all everyone here tonight. I want to greet you in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. I just want to run to a portion of scripture from 1 Corinthians chapter number 2, verse number 9 to 10, and I'll read in your hearing. 1 Corinthians chapter number 2. Reading from verse number 9 to 10. The Bible says, "But as it is written, eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, neither have it entered into the hearts of men the things which God has prepared for them that love him. But God has revealed it unto us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of God." And if I can just read it in the NIV version. It says, "However, as it is written, what no eyes have seen, what no ears have heard, and what no human mind have conceived, the things God has prepared for those who love him. These are the things God has revealed to us by his Spirit. The Spirit searcheth all things, even the deep things of God." Father, I look to you right now. Lord God, as a vessel to be used, I pray, God, that I will decrease and you will increase. Send the word for your people tonight. Move by your Spirit right now in Jesus' name. Before you take your seat, help me announce my theme for tonight. It's already done. Tell your neighbor, it's already done. And you may be seated in the presence of God. The conference topic is advancing and expanding the kingdom of God. And when we look at advance and we think of moving forward in a purposeful way, expanding really means that you're becoming more larger and more extensive. And so we look in the scripture tonight that has been read in the book, rather 1 Corinthians. It reveals some problems and pressures and struggles that was going on in the church. And they were living in a pagan society, and therefore there were things that needed to be addressed. And the church we know in Corinth was founded by Paul on his second missionary journey. And the most serious problem that the Corinthians church had was worldliness and an unwillingness to divorce the culture in which they were living in. Most of the believers there could not separate themselves from their old selfish, moral, and pagan ways. And so it became necessary then for Paul to write to these church and to understand that there's got to be a separation if you want to go where God wants you to go. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. There are some people that are in your life that needs, hallelujah, to go. Because if you're going to expand and if you're going to move in the kingdom of God, you've got to realize that not every and anyone is going to go with you. Praise the name of the Lord, somebody. Their mindset is stuck. Amen. Praise God. Based on where they're coming from, their mindset is stuck based on where they are in life, and they find it very hard to move on, very hard to go forward in God. But I'm here to let you know that, amen, for you to move forward, you've got to have a mind of Christ. It is not the mind of man that's going to push you, but amen, praise God, because really and truly, if it was up to us, if it was up to me, praise God, I may not be here tonight. But thanks be to God, he gave me the victory that I can stand in your house and declare the works of the Lord. That had it not been for the Lord who was on my side, where would I be tonight? Oh, praise the name of the Lord. And so we look in the scripture, Isaiah 64 and verse 4 says, "For since the beginning of the world, men have heard and not perceived by the ear, neither hath the seen, O God, beside thee, what hath prepared for him that waited for him." I know sometimes, hallelujah, hallelujah. It's hard to wait on God because in our mind we have a perception of where we want to go. We have, amen, a time frame of what we, when we want it to be done. But I'm here to let you know, praise the name of the Lord, you may not see it, but it's already done. Hallelujah. You got to believe it in your spirit. You got to speak it in your spirit. You got to dream it. You got to wake up. You got to talk it and believe what God is saying. Because I'm here to let you know there's certain things that is only revealed through the Spirit of God. Man can't tell you. It doesn't matter how I try to comfort you. It doesn't matter how I tell you everything is going to be all right. Unless God speak it in your spirit and declare it in your spirit, it's very hard for you to conceive it in Jesus' name. Come on, give God a praise, somebody. And so your expansion is not going to reveal, hallelujah, through what, amen, people are thinking or what people are saying. It's not based on anyone's opinion. If that's the case, hallelujah, I said already, I would have thrown in the towel. But your expansion is based on the wisdom of God. And only God can reveal the things through the Spirit, what he has for you. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. Natural faculties cannot grasp the greatness of what lies ahead for us as believers. But we have got to get a glimpse of it, praise the name of the Lord, because if you don't see where you're going, it's very hard to move forward. Hallelujah. There were certain things that God revealed to the prophets of old, certain revelation that God made known even to Paul in the New Testament. Church, praise God. But there's still a lot more that needed to be, oh, hallelujah, to be addressed. Still a lot more that needed to be revealed. And not everything, hallelujah, that you're going to aim and find, hallelujah, the word of God. Sometimes God is just going to speak a word in your spirit to let you know, praise God. Amen. Maybe you didn't get a chance to read that book yet, but God, amen, overstepped it and he just came and let me know. Amen. Praise God. I got a feeling that everything is going to be all right. I'm here to let somebody know tonight. It's already done. Praise God. I know it's uncomfortable, as the preacher said last night, but I'm here to let somebody know that it's already done. Clap your hands and give God a praise. Amen. Pat yourself on your chest and say, it's already done. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. God in his grace has revealed to us, and he has prepared amazing and wonderful things for those that love and trust him. Indeed, the Lord himself said that he is God to prepare a place for us, and in my Father's house are many mansions. And if we're not so, I would have told you so. I'm here to let you know there's some things that God is getting ready. Hallelujah. You may not see it yet, but praise God. Hallelujah. It's coming your way. You may not understand it yet, but it's coming your way. Is there somebody in the house that's willing to know it's already done? That's why, praise God, I don't have to worry about the source, because God is my source. I don't have to worry where the money is coming from, because God will make a way out of no way. Is there somebody tonight that's willing to lift your hands? You don't see the way yet, but God said it's already done. You don't understand how it's going to be done, but God said it's already done. You don't know how it's going to come through, but God said it's already done. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. Clap your hands and give God a praise. The deep things of God are only revealed, hallelujah, amen, praise God, to the child of God. And that's why, as a child of God, you got to have the Spirit of God in you. Because when the Spirit is in you, oh, praise the name of God, things that others don't see, you can see it through the Spirit. And not everybody's going to see what God is telling you. Oh, praise God, somebody. But when God speaks in your spirit, when God said you can do all things through me who strengthened you, you don't have to worry about who talking about you. You don't have to worry, you don't like her. But praise God, you know what God is saying. Verse 9 and 10 often speaks out of context, because the two verse speaks of the blessing of a believer. It speaks of what is hidden from those who believe. And we can't imagine that God is in store for us. Amen. The things that we have in life. Listen, I'm here to let you know, praise God. Amen. Coca-Cola sold only 400 Cokes
amen, in the first year. Hallelujah. Henry Ford went bankruptcy twice in 3 years. Amen. In the first, amen, 3 years. Michael Jordan, he was cut from his team. Hallelujah. In his high school years. I'm here to let you know the pandemic stole some things from you. Amen. Some of you are still trying to recover. But praise God, God is getting ready to expand. God is getting ready to enlarge. Is there somebody tonight that's not willing to quit? But hold on to God's unchanging hand. God is gonna do it for you. Tell somebody, don't quit. Don't you quit. Don't you quit fighting. Don't you quit holding open. Don't you quit dreaming. God has it in store for you. What God has for you, it is for you. Is there somebody that's no, it's already done tonight? Your healing is already done. Your blessing is already done. Let your praise God anyhow. Never, never let your troubles get you down. Don't give up on God. We live in a hopeless generation, but we serve a great big God. And that's why here tonight, I'm letting you know that it's already done. As I get ready to take my seat, I want you to put your hands in the air and trust God and say it's already done. I can't see it, but it's already done. God is starting it. God is going to finish it. God is starting it. God is going to finish it. You may not see the end, but it's coming up. It's already done. It's already done. I don't see it, but I believe it. Because my spirit tells me. God revealed it to me. It's not based on anybody's opinion. It is not based on what you think, but it's what God revealed through the Spirit. There's some great things coming your way, but you gotta trust God. You gotta see God, hallelujah, doing it for you. Praise the name of the Lord. It is not by might, it is not by power, but it's by the Spirit of God. It's already done. God bless you in Jesus' name.
If you know it's already done, why don't you continue to clap your hands here in the sanctuary? Come on, let's get up on our feet.
Just don't.
name. And as we gather in the name of Jesus, hallelujah, for he is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah, everyone help me sing.
Praise him.
Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus,
shout the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
Healing in the name of Jesus.
Right here.
Oh, worship him.
This is my
a sacrifice, Jesus.
Bow down, bow down and worship. Oh,
If you agree with me, then join me and sing. To worship you, I live. To worship you. Sometimes when we don't have any more words to sing, we sing, oh, 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 oh.
Worship to the Lord tonight. Come on, worshipers, where are you at? Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. I love you, Jesus.
I worship and adore you.
Just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you more than anything.
Sing it again. I love you.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and adore you.
I worship and adore you.
Just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
Sing it again.
Lord,
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and adore you.
I worship and adore you.
Just want to tell you.
Just want.
Can we just lift both hands to heaven and worship him tonight? Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Love you, Jesus.
Glory to God.
I worship and adore you. Just want to tell you.
Come on and tell him I love you. Lord,
I love you more than anything.
Sing it again. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Lord. For the last time, let's see if it. I love you, Jesus. I love you.
I love you,
glory to God. I worship and adore you.
I worship and adore you.
Just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Let's just pray at this time. Everybody, let's pray at this time. Everybody, let's pray at this time. Come on, let's pray at this time. Hold on to the chair before you and just pray. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you tonight. Hallelujah. We give you the glory. We give you the honor. We give you the praise for what you're going to do in our midst tonight. Hallelujah. Let your name be exalted. Let your name be praised. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Pastor Noah, glory be to God. Glory be to God. Lead us into this prayer, please. Let us praise the Lord. Let us continue to praise the Lord tonight. Lord Jesus, once again, this family is in your presence, in the presence of my God, in your presence, Lord Jesus. In the presence, Lord God, of our Bishop, Diocesan Bishop Smith, Lord God, our Suffragan Bishops, our Lord God pastors, and our ministers, Lord, we are all before you here in this congregation today, pleading with you, Lord Jesus, in a special way, in the name of Jesus Christ.
that there will be special grace of God upon this house tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, in the name of the Lord Jesus, the princes have gathered in Jesus' name, Lord, and we pray that the forces of evil, the forces of despotism, the forces of the enemy, there will be no place for them in this place. In the name of Jesus Christ, let the fire of the Holy Spirit that fell upon the apostle fall upon everyone tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ, let him set to move us in the direction of God, hallelujah, that will bring about your glory and your praise in the name of Jesus. Someone, oh God, has come into this house today hoping to receive from you. Somebody been wondering for a long time. They've been in a situation, my God, that they could not shake off. But in the name of Jesus Christ, the church of the Lord Jesus has gathered tonight. In Jesus' name, let them be able to shake it off in the name of Jesus Christ. Someone, oh Lord, is in dire need, and we are trusting you under the power of the Holy Spirit that, Lord, you will reach out to them and that you will provide that need. Someone is sick. In Jesus' name, Lord, we pray that you will bring healing in the house tonight. Someone needs, Lord God, a word of wisdom. Someone needs a word of knowledge, and we are depending on you. In the name of Jesus Christ, walk up and down in this place. Have your will, Lord, and let everyone present in the place leave with the glory of God totally saturated in their spirit and in their soul. Let our hearts, oh God, now be perfect before you because of your presence in the midst of your people. We thank you for it. We glorify your name. We are looking, my God, for signs and wonders and miracles, Lord, in the name of Jesus. For this is your place. This is your house. And you said, my house shall be called the house of prayer for all people. Now show up and let it be known that your house shall be called a place of prayer for all people. In Jesus' name.
Somebody say amen. Jesus. Somebody say hallelujah. Come on, say hallelujah. Come on, shout hallelujah. Clap your hands, all you people. I said, clap your hands, all you people. And shout unto God with the voice of prayer. Please remain standing. Praise God. I know you've been standing for a little while, but please remain standing. We're going to be reading our scripture for our council. Amen. Please remain standing. We're going to invite all the way from Edmonton. Amen. Pastor Clive Atkins to do the honor for us tonight. In Jesus' name. Please make him feel welcome, everybody. Praise the name of Jesus.
Come on, give God a praise. You can do better than that. Give God a praise. You can do better than that. Give God a praise. I can't hear you. Give God a praise. Hallelujah. 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 Amen, amen. I'm here just to read the scripture tonight. Just want to give honor to the Spirit of God in this house. Come on, give God a praise. Hallelujah. And to our bishop, amen. And to all the delegates tonight, we give God thanks. Amen. Let us turn our Bibles to St. Matthew 11 verses. I'm going to read 11 and 12. Amen. When you find it, say amen. Come on, I want to hear you. When you find it, say amen. 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 We're going to do something different. We're going to read together, nice and loud. It's only two verses. Amen? Amen. Amen. Let us read. Verily I say unto you, among them that are born of a woman, there are notwithstanding, he that is least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he. And from the day the kingdom of heaven suffereth violence, and the violence take it by force. Praise here the goes the
somebody of God's say word. Praise the Lord for the reading of the word. Come on, say praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Up there in York Region, our church is called Chosen Generation, and we have a song that we sing
you know, you are a chosen generation. Anybody know that song? But Pastor Clive is from Edmonton, and his assembly is called Higher Ground. And by the grace of the Lord, if the Lord says the same, we will be there next year, God's willing. Amen. In the month of June. Praise God. So we are actually bound for higher ground. Somebody say amen. I'm bound for higher ground. I am seeking a golden crown. I can't remain in this earthly place. I'm bound for higher. Come on, somebody. I'm bound for higher ground. Seeking a city, a home, and a crown. I can't remain in this lowly place. I'm bound.
I'm gonna make it this morning.
Will you all sit down, please? Thank you, Lord. You may be seated. Of the Lord. I'm pressing on the upward way. Excuse me, sorry. New heights I'm gaining. Every day, still praying, I'm onward bound. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. My heart has no desire. Where doubts arise and fears dismay, though some may dwell where these abound, my prayer, my aim, help me somebody, is somebody raise your hands and let me say, Lord, lift me up and let me stand. My faith on heaven stands for no higher name than I have found. Praise the Lord. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. I feel like praising Him. Glory be to God. Somebody say hallelujah down there. Well. Welcome to our second night. Amen. Of this 31st session of the Canada District Council. Let's put our hands together for the Lord Jesus. Come on, let's give Him praise for real. And we give God thanks tonight for what He's doing in our midst and how He's expanding us and enlarging our territory. Will you please join me with a hand clap tonight as we celebrate God's man for this region, our diocesan, the Honorable Dr. Barrington E. Smith. Let's give God praise for him. Come on, somebody, let's praise God for real. Amen. Amen. And his dear wife, come on, let's give God thanks for our First Lady. For the council, praise God, minister, amen, Corrine Smith. Let's give God praise for her, everybody. Praise God, amen. And our chairman for this council, I must confess to you, we have the best. Somebody say amen to that. Amen. We thank God for this man of God. Praise God, a visionary. We give God thanks for him. A good compliment to our diocesan. And let's give God praise for the Honorable Suffragan Bishop. Amen. Jermaine Hurst. Let's give God praise for him, everybody. Praise God. Amen. And his dear wife, Lady Hurst. Let's give God praise for her as well. Amen. A songbird. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. Somebody said praise the Lord again. Amen. Let's give God thanks for the band. Let's give it up for the band.
Amen. And our praise team tonight, let's give God praise for them. Somebody say amen. Praise God. Our fine ushers are in the house. Give God praise for them, everybody. Praise God. I wonder if there are any worshipers in here tonight. Let's give God praise for the worshipers. Can I hear the worshipers, sir? Amen. We want to welcome all of you tonight to this great council. Praise God. This is held here at our cathedral, the main church in our diocese. And this is Kingdom Life. And I want to tell you, Kingdom Life is known for a whole lot of things. The band is hype. The praise team is top notch. But the word is on fire here. And I want to let you know that wherever you sit, somebody already shouted in that seat. Amen. That seat is broken in, so we want you to kick off the bridges tonight. Amen. Ain't nobody going to study you if you try to act like you're uppity. Just let loose and give the Lord a praise when you feel it. Somebody say amen. Amen. Let me see you try out the role you're in. Just stand up and say hallelujah. See if there's anybody going to respond to you. Praise God. Amen. If nobody shouted in your row, the next opportunity you get, just switch a seat. Don't let them know. Just stick your finger up and move. Praise God. Let me say hallelujah again. Somebody down there. Come on. Let's say hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. God bless you. Amen. We don't want to go on tonight. Amen. We are going to, amen, be receiving, amen, the offering tonight. Praise God. Amen. I hope you didn't come empty-handed. Amen. At least you must have your card or your phone or some device so you can participate, amen, in the worship of giving. Somebody say amen. Praise God. If you don't have it, don't feel any way, but if you have it, give something. Amen. Peter and John says, look on us. Amen. Silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, what? Give ID. So if you got something, give it tonight. Amen. Help me welcome tonight our chairman. He's going to come, praise God, and do this part of the worship. Amen. Amen. There's a D in his name. Praise God. Jermaine D. Hurst. And that D stands for dollars. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. Amen.
Our vice chairman is a comedian tonight. Let's just give God a praise if you know that he's wonderful. We thank God. Listen, the glory of God is in this house tonight. Let me say it again. The glory of God is in this house tonight. I didn't say the presence of God, because the presence of God is always around. When we say the glory of God, that means there's healing in the room, deliverance in the room, favor in the room, increase in the room. I said the glory of the Lord is in the house tonight. And his train has filled the temple. Now, if you can see him, the spirit, if you can really sense and see him, the spirit, the Bible says that God is a, and they that must worship him in what? So there's two things. You need truth and you need spirit. Now I know that God is the truth and God is spirit. But what he's saying is to us, you have to worship him in spirit and you have to do it truthfully and know who he is. Now just right now, I know we've worshiped, but without the music, without the praise team, without any cheerleading and without the preacher saying, tell your neighbor. I wonder right now if anybody is in love with Jesus and you believe in God, that your blessing is already in the room and it belongs to you. It's here right now in this glory. I dare you right now. I don't care what kind of praise you have. I dare you to get God's attention tonight. Ha! Come on, just for 2 minutes. Hallelujah. Come on, for 2 minutes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, for 2 minutes, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on. Claim your healing. Claim your deliverance. Claim your authority. Claim your favor. Claim that building. Claim that ministry. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on, musicians. Without the music, come on. Lift them hands, musicians. Come on. Hallelujah. Your music is just your expression. You are Levites. I need the ushers to worship. I need every pastor to worship. I need those of you on Facebook to worship. Those of you on YouTube to worship. Let everything that hath breath. Come on, 30 more seconds. 30 more seconds. Come on, open up your mouth. Tell the Lord that you love him. I need somebody to lay your hands on your neighbor. Come on and pray over their life right now. Come on. Touch somebody next to you. Be healed in Jesus' name. Be healed in Jesus' name. Or come on, help me pray for somebody in this atmosphere. Be healed. Be blessed. Your breakthrough. 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 Help us, musicians, just play. Now, everybody, clap your hands. Come on. I need some people in the aisle right now. Clap. I need some clappers in the aisles right now. I need somebody to march around and clap. I need somebody to leave your seat. I need some folks to move around. I need you to leave your seat. Claim some territory. Come on, Mr. Gelder. Go wave that in the aisle. Wave that in the aisle. Go with that. Come on, pastors. Come on, pastors. Get something in your hand. Everybody, get something in your hand. Wave it in the air. Come on, claim your victory. Claim your victory. Claim your victory. Claim your victory. Claim. Come on, church. Get something in your hand. Get something in your hand. Wave it in the air. Get something in your hand. We belong to God. Favor in this atmosphere. Hey, glory, glory, glory. Shataya, Ikanama, glory, Emaya, glory, Ikoto, Shadanaba, Hayaya, Ikanaboshi. Yes, 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 Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes. Somebody lift your hand and say, I'm healed in Jesus' name. Wave one finger up and say, victory in Jesus' name. I need everyone to point to the back door there, to the front of the house, and say, in the name of Jesus, we command every sickness, every disease that's in our bodies and in this room to leave right now, in the name of Jesus, to a deserted place, in Jesus' name. Now cast it out in Jesus' name. Yeah. Hallelujah. You may be seated. You may be seated. Hakata. Hukosha. Woo. 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 Yeah. Oh yeah. That's glory. That's glory right there. That's glory. Ah, that's glory right there. That's glory. That's glory. Oh yeah, the glory's here. The glory's in the room. The glory's in the room. The glory's in the room. I'm turning, I'm turning, I'm turning. I'm turning, I'm turning, I'm turning. God is turning and flipping and turning stuff upside down, Bishop. And he's putting us in our rightful place. We are blessed tonight. We are blessed tonight. We are blessed tonight. Bishop, this is why the devil didn't want us to come together. He wanted COVID to keep us apart. Because there's something when two or three are gathered together in his name. He says, there am I in the midst of them. Somebody just blow Jesus a kiss. Come on. Lord, we love you. Oh, yata, bashanda. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. We honor our Lord tonight. We thank God. Amen. Protocol has been set, but we must honor the set man of the house. And we thank God for our diocesan, the Honorable Bishop Barrington E. Smith. Let's give God a praise for him, his wife. We thank God for all of our executive officers and to our executive board members, Suffragan bishops, district elders, to all of our wives and spouses and to all of the ministers. Amen. Let those that are clergy, can the clergy stand? Let the clergy stand. Don't they look nice in their uniform? Let's give God a praise for all the ministers, elders, evangelists, pastors. Thank you so much. Didn't we have an awesome time on last night? Amen. And we had a wonderful time on today, throughout the day. And we're just thankful because God is faithful. We thank God for the wonderful word that we heard from our very own district elder, Weston Richards. Amen. It's already done. It's already done. Powerful word. And we thank God for the praise team and these minstrels playing out of their heart and soul. Let's give God a praise. We're having church and we're very thankful to God. Well, it's offering time. Can we celebrate them now? Oh, come on. The praise shouldn't get weak. You know, it is a blessing to give. The Bible teaches us, and Jesus says, give, and it shall be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, shall men given to your bosom. It is the law of reciprocity. Jesus is saying, if I can trust you to give, then I can get in someone else's mind to give back to you. And I am a living witness that you can't beat God giving. The more we give, the more God blesses us even more. I'm thankful that during COVID, I didn't go hungry. There was food on my table every day, clothes on our backs. I thank God that my whole entire family got COVID and we walked out of it by the grace of God. I'm not ashamed. Some people are ashamed to say they had COVID, like it's the cooties or something. Amen. But there are millions of people that received COVID and got sick and didn't come out. But look at us. Look what the Lord has done. God always gives to us. I can go on, and Bishop was just sharing with me in the corner. He said, can you believe only 15 years? I was sitting there and I saw the 55th Episcopal District. And I was reminiscing as Suffolk and Bishop Christie was ministering, and he's I thank God for him because he's sensitive to the Spirit. He knows how to flow in worship. You can tell he's a worshiper. And he loves God, and just sharing some things in my heart with him because he's a worshiper. And I understand where he comes from when he says certain things to me about worship. And while he was worshiping and celebrating, I thought about what to say when I came up. And I thought about how Bishop and I were a part of the New York State Council at that time, New York State and Ontario District Council, then New York State and Canada District Council. But for those of you that don't know, New York is the first Episcopal district of the Pentecostal Assemblies of the World. And you look at times and you recognize where you come from. And my pastor was the late Suffragan Bishop Dees. He was the Suffragan Bishop in Canada. It was through him that I met the Smiths. And he sent me to Kingdom Life earlier in its infancy to come and minister the word because he couldn't come. And it was my first time coming to Canada all those years ago, was with Kingdom Life when they were at the community center at the time. And I didn't know that we would be where we are right now. But can I submit this to you? Someone invested. Someone invested their time, their talent, their treasure. People have given. And because of the faithfulness of so many with faith, we are here today. Some of you, we were blessed to see some of our young people now that are now leading in the council, and they were little babies running around and come on, with diapers on, and come on, y'all not saying anything. Now they're preachers and ministers and leading. And I remember earlier in those district meetings that you can probably fit all of us in a little room. Suffolk and Bishop Tulloch was there. Could fit a few of us in a McPherson and Tulloch. And it was maybe five different pastors. And everyone had faith to believe God for more. But we didn't know that in the midst of us was our next bishop. And we didn't know what God had a plan. I wasn't Suffolk and Bishop Hurst. He wasn't Suffolk and Bishop Tulloch. And who knew that the man that came in the midst made us Suffolk and bishops? What I'm saying is that when people sow into your life, we have a reason to bless this great council. I don't know about you, but it is a blessing that when I walk in here, I know when people say they are praying for me, I believe it. I know that when I walk in and come to our council, you're going to get a word from the Lord. And now, there are no perfect council. There are no perfect people. But we do serve a perfect God. So let somebody shout hallelujah. So we're asking you to give. We want you to sow. We want you to invest. We have some wonderful plans in the business session. We thank God for Pastor Atkinson being with us tonight. And we have some saints all the way from Edmonton that came all the way here. Can you stand, those that came from Edmonton? Let's give God a praise. Come on, from the West Coast. Praise God. Now, from what I understand, that's more than a couple of hours away. Amen. More like a couple of days, I'm hearing. But they are here in Jesus' name, and it takes investment and sacrifice to be here. And the Lord has blessed, and our bishop has shared it as well, and our vice chairman, that in 2023, if the Lord helps us, and if we still remain, we are heading to Edmonton in June of 2023. Let's give God a praise for that. And so we want you to sow, because there's so many things we want to do, because it is our mindset to carry this glorious gospel. And I'll say this before I open up the doors and the floodgates for the offerings. Our bishop is blessed because in the Pentecostal assemblies of the world, we don't understand the magnitude of his positioning. Do you not know that he is the only bishop diocesan that is covering the Canada from the east to the west, from north and south? Do you not know because of that we are responsible to hold up the arms of the man of God and to go forth? Because God didn't just call him. God called all of us. And how many of you believe right now that Canada is not second rate because we're not in the U.S.? Oh, y'all mighty quiet. See, I'm from the U.S., so I can talk like this. You're not second rate. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? I'm here to let everybody know I want your Canadian money tonight. Because you are not second rate. Because our council has vision. And when I look at the First Episcopal District to the 55th, we are doing well as a new council. Clap your hands for the grace of God. So I'm going to make a sacrifice tonight. I know that all of our pastors are called to do certain things, but I'm going to start this. I'm going to make a sacrifice, and I'm giving $500 tonight because I want to set it in the soil, because I'm believing God for something for my wife and I and our church family, and I'm sowing in good ground at the Canada amen. District Council. Can we say amen? So I'm asking those of you that will follow, I'm asking those pastors, if we can have our treasurer, and if we can have our team to come, amen, and if we can come, our finance team, or whoever's receiving the offering. Is Brother Peart in the room with us? He's in the back. All right, if they can come forward, and the team that will be coming with him, and we're very thankful to God. I need the musicians. Brother Dylan, can you all play this? I don't know if you know this song, but it's time to give some big money music. Now, whatever that selection may be, brother, I don't know what the bass run it is for Brother Baker, but if we can find that key, we can find it somewhere where we're going to receive tonight. Yeah, good. Can you help me with that? Amen. In case some people wanted to know what is the amounts for the
praise the Lord, everybody. Yeah, go. Amen. Just for information.
Stand with him too, yeah. You stand
with him. Praise the Lord, everybody. Just for information, if you look at the screen and if you can't see it from where you are, there are three ways we are asking you to give. You can give, well, of course, in person here tonight, or if you're watching us by stream, you can give, or if you're here and you have your electronic device, you can give by way of e-transfer at donations@canadapaw.ca. Again, donations@canadapaw.ca. Or if you're across the border or whatever, if you've got a PayPal account,
amen,
give out of that, you may do so as well.
Yes, those are streaming too.
Hey, those are streaming as well. Though you can give by those means. And if you're expecting some money after tonight, like sometime later in the week, please remember us. The platforms are
praise,
still available.
Praise God. Praise God.
But you can send something in the mail if you so desire.
All right.
We are asking our leadership to follow the trend by
Amen.
Our vice chairman. Amen. Bishop, you were asked for $350 offering. So Bishop is giving $600. Praise the Lord.
Give it up for our bishop.
Amen. Let's give God praise. You
beat me. Bishop said, I can't let you beat me. Give it up for our bishop.
Amen.
For
praise the Lord.
$600. Thank you,
Amen.
Bishop.
Our sovereign right. bishops, we had asked you to prepare to give a $200 offering. Praise God. I have already transferred mine, so if you don't see me go in my pocket, don't judge me. Amen. So, our sovereign bishops, $200.
All right.
Amen. Our emeritus senior suffragan bishop here, 175.
Okay.
District.
All right. District elders, 150. If you can bring that, brethren, whatever your gift is, come. Yep. We want to serve them because they're giving. I don't even want them to walk. Can we have someone to collect from them? Amen. They're looking so good in their attire. Let's give it up for our pastors. Come on, suffragan bishop. Hopeton Morris says, give God a praise for him. District Elder Richards, Suffragan Bishop Hutchinson. Amen. Suffragan Bishop Tullock. Amen. Pastor Atkinson, District Elder Bolton. No, come on, clap your hands for our pastors. Amen. Clap your hands for our pastors. Now, I thank God for the first ladies, the women of God. Don't they look wonderful tonight? I thank God for my beautiful wife, Pastor D. Amen. Come on, clap your hands for them. Amen. And they look so beautiful with their pink and black and the combination on last night. And so I am asking. You have not because you what? That was kind of weak. I want all the women to repeat the scripture. You have not because you. Now, how many women that are married know how to ask your husband for stuff? See, there we go. I am asking. Oh, wait. I can't. Wait a minute. That would be unfair for me to go to the first ladies first when we got all those preachers over there with collars on. Now, I don't have no power to do this, but all of y'all are bishops tonight. I'm prophetically putting the call of diocesan on your spirit, but it's going to end after offering. It's going to end after offering time. I'm asking every preacher, can you give us $100 tonight? I'm asking every preacher to give us $100 tonight. And I'm asking our first ladies if you would join us with $50 tonight. And those of you, every preacher in the house, if you can give us $100 and $50 from our first ladies. And all for the first ladies, I got a word for you. If you don't have it, go find your husband. Send him a text. Because sometimes it comes out the same basket. But please. Do accordingly. All right. And so we don't have to have everyone to come up, but we're asking all of you to give. Now, those of you that are the members of the CDC, I'm asking as many of you, because we want to meet the budget and we want to go forth and do the things we want to do. I'm asking all of you to give a $40 tonight. Somebody say $40. $40 is the number of testing. So let's pass the test. I'm asking everyone for $40 tonight. No less than that tonight. Amen, somebody? Now, how many of you believe we can do that in Jesus' name? I said, how many of you believe we can do that in Jesus' name? Amen, somebody. So we thank God for that. I'm going to pray. We have our treasury team. Are we going to stand here, Brother Pitt? Where are we standing? In the middle? All right, and we thank God for Brother Iris as well with a basket. And so I'm going to pray, and then we're going to put you into the hands of our ushers that will direct us.
We don't have to call everybody's name because God knows your name. But just sow. And we believe that if you sow the seed and be a blessing, God will do something wonderful in our midst as he always does. So I ask everyone, if you would please stand. I'm going to pray and then put you into the hands of our ushers. If you're going to make a check, if you're writing your check, we make it out to Canada District Council. Okay, there you go. All right, Inc. Canada District Council, Inc. All of the information is up front. Praise God. Everyone, lift your hands to God. Even if you got the seed in your hand or not, lift your hands to God. Father, we thank you for this opportunity to sow, this opportunity to give. We thank you, God, because you love cheerful givers. So we give cheerfully, not grudgingly. We give with the right attitude because you are Jehovah Jireh, our provider. Lord, we thank you for even giving us something to give tonight. And we know that it is you that gives the increase. So Lord, bless every house, bless every church, bless every ministry, bless every seed that is sown. Receive our gift and receive us and continue to increase every house. In Jesus' name, can we say amen? You are now in the hands of our ushers. God bless you.
Everybody say bless, bless, bless.
Come on, put your hands together, everybody.
Come on, we're blessing the city.
Oh, we're blessed in the
city. Come on,
we're blessed in the field. We're blessed when we come and when we go. We cast down every stronghold, sickness and poverty must be. For the devil is defeated. We are blessed. Feel. Yeah.
Amen. Put your hands together as you remain standing. As you remain standing, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of God. We thank God for this time and this platform that God has blessed us, man of God, to have to feed the flock of God. Amen. We have a psalmist, amen, in the person of Sister Ashley Denton. Yes, I know Sister Ashley. Sister Ashley Denton, as she's coming. And the next voice you will hear is our diocesan, the Honorable Bishop Barrington E. Smith. Let's clap our hands for both of them as they minister on tonight. Sister Ashley.
Praise the Lord. Shall we lift up the name of Jesus? Hallelujah. First and foremost, I want to greet the presence of Jesus Christ that is in our midst. And then to the angel of this house, my Bishop, Bishop Smith, First Lady Smith, Bishop Hurst and Lady Hurst, rostrum associates in your respective position, I greet you in the name of Jesus. Worship with me as I sing this song. In case you have fallen by the wayside of life, dreams and visions shattered, you're all broken inside. You don't have to stay in the shape that you're in, because the Potter wants to put you back together again. In case your situation has turned upside down, and all that you've accomplished is now on the ground, you don't have to stay in the shape that you're in, because the Potter wants to put you back. Put you back together again. You who are broken, stop by the Potter's house. Ooh, you who need mending, stop by the you back together again, Jesus, Jesus, oh, Jesus, there is something about the name of Jesus. And that's why I call him Master and Savior, Master and Savior and Jesus. Like a fragrance after the rain. something about that name. And kingdoms, they shall all pass away. But there's something, hallelujah, there's something, oh, something about that name. When my time helps me sing, Jesus,
glory, glory, stand to your feet and give God praise. Come on, stand to your feet and give God praise. There is something about the name Jesus. There is something about the name Jesus. Come on, somebody praise Him. There is something. I said there is something about the name Jesus. Somebody call Him by His name. Come on, where are the Jesus worshipers? Come on, open up your mouth and give Him glory. Jesus, Jesus, there is something. I said there is something. There is something about the name Jesus. There's healing in the name of Jesus. There's deliverance in the name of Jesus. There's victory in the name of Jesus. Somebody call Him by His name. Hey, call Him by His name. He's your deliverer. Hey, He's your savior. He's your king. He's your master. I'm talking about Jesus. I said I'm talking about Jesus. Somebody call the name Jesus. There's something, there is something higher, there is something about the name, about the name. Touch your neighbor as a neighbor, there's power in the name of Jesus. Hey! You may be seated in the name of the Lord. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Call Him by His name. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. I am Oshakuta Yamaha. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. He's my rock. He's my deliverer. He's my sword, my shield, my shadow. He's my hiding place, my covering. Yeah, I'm talking about Jesus. I'm talking about the King of Kings. I love Jesus. You may be seated. Woo, Jesus. Oh, somebody stretch over to your neighbor. As a neighbor, he's talking about Jesus. Yes. Oh, there's something. God bless you, Sister Ashley. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Greetings to the CDC. Greetings in the name of Jesus. We certainly welcome you to the Canada District Council, the 55th Episcopal District of the Pentecostal Assemblies of the World. Those that are joining us, amen, virtually, and those that are in the house of God, we greet you in Jesus' name. Amen. No other name but the name of Jesus. Amen. I certainly want to greet our chairman, amen, Suffragan Bishop Jermaine Hurst. Put your hands together for him. And for our vice chairman, amen, Suffragan Bishop Carlton Christie. To our senior Suffragan Bishop, amen. God bless you. He's been with us.
a long time, always in. God bless you, Suffragan Bishop George Tuller. Put your hands together for a senior Suffragan Bishop, to all our other Suffragan Bishops, district elders, to our executive board, our general secretary and general treasurer, and all those that work with us, our pastors, all the ministers. You look so lovely tonight. Evangelists, ministers, amen, elders, missionaries, deacons. You look so lovely tonight. God bless you for your obedience to all the saints that are here. I greet you in Jesus' name. How about you put your hands together for our fine ushers, amen, of the Canada District Council. How about for our praise team and our musicians? Come on. Our media team, they're in the background, but they're doing a fantastic job. We bless God for the media team and for everyone that work in ministry. Amen. I have a couple of announcements and I'll preach for, amen. How much time should I preach? 30 minutes? 25? 35? Amen. Say it's about 25, 30 minutes. Amen. Tonight, we've got a lot of word, but I have a couple of announcements I want to make before. Amen. I want to encourage everyone to please support our CDC conference. Amen. This is, we're building something in Canada. Amen. And we are going greater heights. We're going to get ready to welcome two new churches. Amen. By the time I reach the end of this service. Amen. And we'll introduce you a little bit later on. That's growth. Come on, put your hands together. Last year, October, we had two new churches. We have two more. That's growth. And there's an application that's coming in right now. So God is expanding the Canada District Council. But I just want to announce that Bishop Barrington Smith and his wife is taking a journey to Egypt and Israel May 8th through the 20th of 2023. Now, this is going to be my final trip for a while, because I've been there like 6 times. And this is my final trip for a while. Bishop Hurst was with us. Amen. Lady Hurst, we had a great time. They renewed their vows. Amen. By the Sea of Galilee. And so we're going to climb Mount Sinai. We're going to travel the Exodus journey from Egypt through Israel. And so if you want to come with me, this is your last chance. We have about 12 or 14 people signed up already, maximum of 30. And so please join us. Amen. May Council. Amen. Mark it in your calendar. I want next year council in May to be one where you take the day off on a Friday and just come and spend time with us in the council. Is that all right? Is that all right? Just book it from now and take the day off and spend the time with us. This announcement is very important. We're having an Edmonton expansion, Alberta expansion. We have one church in Alberta, and look at the number of saints that came down from Alberta with Pastor Atkinson. We're so grateful. Amen. But we have another church that's put in their application, and we're going to Alberta on June 1st, 2nd, and 3rd. You heard it. But we have an Alberta expansion or Edmonton expansion campaign where I'm looking for 200 people to give $100 by December 31st. I have already sold my $100. We have over $1,000, I think, already. Over 10 people have sown that since they announced it. And so if you can, send a donation. Put in the notes, Edmonton campaign. Expansion, Edmonton expansion in the notes or on the envelope, and God is going to bless you. We're looking for 200 people by December 31st. Can we do it, CDC? Can we do it, CDC? All right. Amen and amen. The last announcement I want to make is on behalf of Pastor Atkinson and Higher Ground. Amen. They have Higher Ground Tabernacle Radio. They have a radio station. And it has an app, HGG Radio, I think it is. Let me put my glasses back on. Amen. I'm 58 on November 1st. You can send me my birthday gift. Amen. Higher Ground Gospel Radio, known as HGG Radio, is owned and operated by Higher Ground Tabernacle Ministry. You can download that app. You can get it from the Play Store, from the Apple Store, wherever it is. So whichever device you have, download it. You can begin listening. They're on every day. And the more listeners they have, the better it's going to be, the greater the expansion. And so I'm encouraging every CDC member to go download that app. If you have questions, see anybody from Alberta, anybody from Edmonton can help you with this. Is that all right? Amen. Come on, put your hands together and praise God for Higher Ground. Amen, Pastor Atkinson. Can you stand with me with the word of the Lord? I certainly salute the First Lady of our council and my wife of 33 years. And to all the First Ladies, all the pastors and ministers' wives, God bless you in Jesus' name. Matthew chapter 11, verse 10 to 12. Now, we had good preaching last night.
Amen. Both by Minister Dulcie Davis, Suffragan Bishop Darrell Farah. We had Suffragan Bishop Jermaine Hurst in the morning. Then we had, amen, District Elder Weston Richards. And now if I can borrow a little bit from everybody's message, we can have a message tonight. For this is he of whom it is written, behold, I send my messenger before thy face, which shall prepare thy way before thee. Verily, I say unto you, among them that are born of women, there hath not risen a greater than John the Baptist. Notwithstanding, he that is least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he. This is Jesus speaking. And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffereth violence, and the violent take it by force. I want to read verse 12 from the NLT version. And from the NLT version, verse 12 says, and from the time John the Baptist began preaching until now, the kingdom of heaven has been forcefully advancing. Huh. And violent people are attacking it. Glory to God. Sisters and brothers, don't be seated yet. The theme for our conference is advancing and expanding the kingdom of God. My subject tonight is by any means necessary. I want you to look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, by any means necessary. Come on, somebody, they don't mean it. Look at another neighbor. I say, neighbor, I don't know how we're going to get it done, but by any means necessary. Is there anybody ready for advancement tonight? Show glory in the house. Hey, hey, do I have a Holy Ghost church in here tonight? Show glory. Somebody show by any means. Any means necessary. I'll scream if I have to scream. I'll run if I have to run. I dance if I have to dance. But by any means necessary. All right, you're not ready. Sit down and let's preach. Woo! By any means necessary. Sisters and brothers, let me run. I'm going to preach for 25 minutes. Let's examine the background of our text. Jesus is here doing kingdom work. He's on earth doing what he came to do. The Bible tells us he was feeding the multitudes. He was calming the raging seas. He was restoring sight to the blind. He was making the lame to walk. He was curing people of leprosy. Dead people were coming to life. And the message of redemption was being preached. You know, I don't know about you, but Jesus was the real deal. Somebody look at your neighbor and say, Jesus was a real deal. You know, there are some people around you, they're fake. They're not real. They act like they're real, but they're fake. But how many know that Jesus is a real deal? Anybody know that the Holy Ghost is real? Anybody have the real Holy Ghost tonight? This is not fake. I'm not putting on a show. This is real. Slap yourself and say, this is real. Woo! The anointing that I feel is real. Can I talk to a real people here tonight? But the Bible said that John and his disciples had some questions. John was the last Old Testament prophet, and he was the ordained forerunner of Jesus. John shook people up. The Bible said he announced the coming of the kingdom of God, and John was unorthodox in his methods. There were extraordinary circumstances concerning his birth. You see, John was different than everybody else. The Bible said he dressed differently. He ate weird stuff, locusts and wild honey. John was a different sort of man. He was a cut above the average. The Bible said that he attracted thousands by his message. And his message challenged the ritualism and the legalism of the religious establishment of that time.
The Bible said that John fearlessly preached about faith and the righteous standards of God. And the Bible tells us that John would not compromise with those of his time when it came to the truth of God. Amen. Why was John the way he was, you may ask? I believe that John was desperate to fulfill his assignment in advancing the kingdom of God. And I don't know about you, but if you're going to go by any means necessary, you've got to be desperate to advance the kingdom of God. Somebody say glory. You see, John knew who Jesus was, but some people around him were skeptical. And the Bible said, if you go to the earlier verses of St. Matthew chapter 11, in verse 2 to 3, the Bible said that when John had heard in the prison the works of Christ, he sent two of his disciples and said unto him, art thou he that should come, or should we look for another? Now, sisters and brothers, John knew who Jesus was. But because of the skepticism that was around him, God bless you, my son. Because of the skepticism that was around him, John sent a message that said, are you he that should come, or should we look for another? You should be careful who you have around you. You should be careful who you have in your circle, because skepticism can deter your message and your advancement in the kingdom of God. Can I preach it like I feel it? Is there anybody here that want to surround yourself with some worshipers? I want to surround myself with some positive people that are advanced in the kingdom of God. Somebody show glory. Somebody show glory. Oh, Bishop, how does that relate to us today as the body of Christ? There are many people in our churches today who want to follow Jesus, but they reject the Bible. Oh, people who sit back and wonder, what is CDC all about? What is the bishop up to? What is the chairman up to? What is the pastor up to? They question the message. They question the direction of the church. And some people stop coming to church altogether. And they use the pandemic as an excuse. They use COVID as an excuse. But the last time I checked, COVID never stopped anybody from going to the supermarket. COVID never stop anybody from shopping. COVID never stop anybody from going to work. Can I preach it like I feel it? And the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, but the violent. Oh, can somebody say amen? Amen. I have 20 minutes left. Oh, glory. Say, preach, Bishop. Amen. They question the direction of the church. And some stop coming to church altogether. Some people stop coming to CDC. They like to watch it virtually. But I want to let you know, there's nothing called a virtual anointing. Good God from glory, can I preach it like I feel it in here? Amen. There's no virtual anointing. Good God from glory, you need to touch and agree. Mighty God of glory. Amen. When you're virtual, I'm not hurting the virtual church, but I want to let you know, there's something about the real deal. And when God starts to move, when the council starts to move, when things start to happen, people are wondering if it's God or not. And they are like John's disciples. They just aren't sure. They aren't sure because they lack knowledge. And so they sent those questions to Jesus. And Jesus started to answer those questions. And when Jesus got to verse number 11, he said, from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffereth violence, and the violence taketh it by force. But you can't understand the scripture until you read verse 13. Verse 13 says, for all the prophets of the law and the law prophesied until John. Can I submit to you that we'll miss the interpretation of the scripture if we only say the kingdom suffer violence and the violent taketh it by force? We got to go and look what Luke had to say about it. And when you go to Luke chapter 16 and verse 16, the Bible said that the law and the prophets were until John. Remember what it said in verse 13, that the prophets and the law prophesied until John. And so Luke picked it up and said the law and the prophets were until John. Since that time, the kingdom of God is preached, and though every man presseth into it, somebody shall press. And if you want to know the rabbinic interpretation, the rabbinic interpretation of this text says the kingdom was breaking forth and the son not suffering from violence. The kingdom is breaking forth. I wonder if there's anybody here know that the kingdom of God is about to break forth in your neighborhood. The kingdom of God is about to break forth in your community. The kingdom of God is about to break forth in Edmonton. We need some people to press into the kingdom of God. I feel the Holy Ghost up in here. And so, sisters and brothers, let me break this down for you a little bit. There's two simultaneous things happening right now. The kingdom of God is breaking into the world as water breaks through a broken dam. Now you got to follow me closely. Amen. Number one, the kingdom of God is breaking forth like water breaks through a dam. The second thing is individuals within the kingdom, they are finding freedom and they're finding liberty. And so you got to understand that there's a breach right now. There's a breach when it comes against what's blocking the people of God. And the breach maker is John. John makes the first breach and he goes through first. The Bible said he makes the way. And after John breaks through, here comes Yeshua. Who is Yeshua, Bishop? I'm talking about Jesus. The Bible said that Jesus is the king. He follows John through the breach and he's leading the sheep. And the Bible said he called his disciples while John was still there. In the days of John, he called his disciples. And since that time, the kingdom is breaking out. It's not futuristic. It's right now. There's a breakout anointing that's in this house right now. Is there anybody here that have the Holy Ghost and you know that you're anointed and you know that no weapon formed against you shall prosper? Somebody jump to your feet for the first time and touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm anointed for this season. I'm anointed for this time. Take your seat. Take your seat. Somebody wave your hand and say glory. 15 more minutes of preaching. Sisters and brothers, bondage is in the world and bondage is common. Most of us are bound in some area of our lives. And even tonight in this very liberated service, we have some people that are bound. Good God from glory, bound financially, bound emotionally, bound spiritually. And most of us spend a whole lot of time focusing on deliverance from habits, deliverance from sickness, deliverance from relationships. And because bondage is common, the cry and the plea for deliverance is not uncommon, because everybody need a deliverance. Right now in this house, there's a need for deliverance. There was a sister here that was under heavy travail, and when I went out there, it's the same thing. Lord, open their eyes. That's what God is showing her. There's a need for a deliverance if we're going to have an advancement. Can I preach it like I feel it? Now, I need to let you know that deliverance is always accompanied by a dilemma. You can't get deliverance without a dilemma. And that's why some of us are struggling. Because when trouble comes, we forget how to praise the Lord. When trouble comes, we don't know how to dance in the spirit. Some of us only know how to dance when everything is going all right. But can I preach to somebody today that although trouble is in my house, I will bless the Lord at all of Oshanda, at all times, and his praise. Somebody slap your neighbor on the hand and say, I bless the Lord. Somebody show glory. Somebody show glory. Somebody show glory. And we got to be willing, sit down, bishops, to navigate the dilemmas in order to experience the victory. I want us to be free, but I want us to understand it takes something to be free. I don't have time to mess with this too much because I only have 12 minutes. But the place that God uses to rescue you can turn into a trap if you stay in that place too long. Oh God, somebody missed that. The place that God used to rescue you, it can turn into a trap if you stay in that place too long. And some of us have been rescued, but we don't know how to advance. Some of us have been rescued, but we are still in the same place, singing the same hallelujah, doing the same dance, shouting the change shout. But it's time for the church to advance. Somebody open your mouth and shout advance. Somebody open your mouth and shout advance. It's time for the church. Hello, Shako Sataya Boshanda. Let me slow down a little bit. I want you to understand this. Some of us have been trapped in a place that was meant to be a place of transition. It was not meant to be a permanent residence. It was meant to be a transitory place. Oh, and there are some people that God bring into your life for a season, and they were not meant to be there forever. And if you keep them in your life, they will seduce you to destruction. And that's why you have to be careful about who you keep in your life for the long haul. Oh God, help me here tonight, Holy Ghost, because not everybody who is a friend is a friend. Oh God, not everybody that called you is a friend. Is there anybody? No, I know one permanent friend. He's ticket closer than a brother. Oh, somebody tell him he's talking about Jesus. Is there anybody here that knows Jesus is your friend? Oh, come on, open up your mouth and call upon your friend. Somebody shout, Jesus, he's my rock, my deliverer, my sword, my shelter, my shepherd. Is there any Jesus worshipers in here? I don't mean to upset you tonight, but nobody ever cares for me like Jesus. Woo! Give me 10 more minutes. Sit down, please. Please do not give permanent residence to seasonal people. Pastor Brown Smith, there are some people who used to be my friends 25 years ago. They're not my friends anymore. Good God from glory. Nothing is wrong with them. Nothing is wrong with me. But guess what? I'm advancing in the kingdom of God. Good God, you've got to know when to say bye-bye. You've got to know when to say bye-bye. Somebody just wave your hand bye-bye to some destructive forces. Say bye-bye to some negative people. Is there anybody know what I'm talking about? There are some negative people. There are some negative people that try to destroy you. But goodbye. So long, bye-bye. So long, bye-bye. Somebody open up your mouth and say, I'm moving on to the higher calling. Then forward still, this Jehovah's will. Though the billows dash and spray with a concrete tread, we will push ahead and roll the sea away. The devil is a liar. Excuse me. I'm pressing on the upward way. New heights I'm gaining. Every day, still praying as I upward bounce, Lord. Somebody show glory. Sit down, let's talk a little bit. Some people came into my life, Bishop, to teach me a lesson. Somebody holler, lesson learned, lesson learned, lesson learned, lesson learned, lesson learned. Come on, you learn your lesson. Say, lesson learned, lesson learned. Amen, I'm moving on, lesson learned. They were seasonal. And it's time to move away from them and make a move. It's time for advancement. Somebody say, it's time for advancement. And advancing the kingdom of God requires desperation. Somebody tell your neighbor, I'm feeling Jesus right here. Somebody reach out to your neighbor, say, neighbor, by any means necessary. Tell them deliverance demands desperation. Glory to God. David heard the defiance of a blasphemous giant. And David cried out in desperation, is there not a cause? Elijah, he threw down his gauntlet to a backslidden nation. And he challenged them, how long will thou halt between two opinions? If God be God, serve him. If Baal be Baal, serve him. I come to announce to the CDC, if you're a Christian, just be a Christian. If you're coming to church, just come to church. If you're gonna live for God, just live for God. Don't bother halt between two opinions. The devil is a liar. I'm moving onwards. Touch your neighbor, say, neighbor, by any means necessary, I'm gonna get what God has for me. By any means necessary, I'm going to claim my victory. By any means necessary, I'm going to receive my breakthrough. By any means necessary, somebody show glory. For the second time, jump up on your feet and roll back your head and show glory. Show glory. Show glory. Show glory. Now give your neighbor a high five and say, by any means necessary. And take your seat. Aya boshato. Akito no boshanda la bahaya. Endo boshakura bakosanda. I have 8 minutes left. Everybody shout, 8 minutes left. Somebody shout, 8 minutes left. But by any means necessary, I'm going to get my deliverance. By any means necessary, I'm going to get my breakthrough. Somebody shout glory. You may be seated. We are a people, bishops, that seek to advance and expand the kingdom of God. And we are desperate for a change. There are some people that are sick and tired of the old stuff. And some people are stopping you and blocking the road, I feel it, Holy Ghost, to advancement. because they are religious status quo. And we have made them feel more important than God. Oh God. But your anointing is not greater than my God. I don't care how much tongues you speak. When I'm ready to bust a move, you can't block me. You can't stop me. You can't hinder me. You can't sabotage me. It's forward still. Is there anybody here that's ready for a move? Is there anybody here that's ready for advancement? Somebody shout, enough is enough. I'm not going to sit here. I'm getting on forward. Somebody shout forward. Somebody shout forward. We have a people today, I'm almost done, who refuses to back down and accept that it has to be the way it always has been. Well, I feel this in my spirit. I refuse to accept that I have to preach the way my daddy preached. I refuse to accept that I have to do ministry the way I saw them do ministry. Somebody say fresh move. Somebody say fresh move. The kingdom cannot be advanced if you're sitting in the same place. And there's a people tonight, and I hope I have 50 of you at least, who are willing to advance the kingdom by any means necessary. A people that's not willing to be comfortable with a status quo. A people that's not willing to be comfortable with good enough. A people that's not willing to be comfortable with just surviving. A people who is not willing to be comfortable with less than. A people who are not willing to be comfortable with being almost whole. Almost free is not enough for me. Almost well is not enough for me. Almost revived is not enough for me. Almost on fire is not enough for me. I'm desperate for advancement. I'm desperate for a move. I'm preaching to somebody here tonight that's desperate for a move by any means necessary. I'm getting ready to close, but it's time that the kingdom of God continue to press forward. Where are those of us who will cry out to God? Where are those of us who will say, if we go, we may die, but if we stay here, we may die? Where are those of us that are willing to press through the crowd till you get your deliverance? Where are those of us who will sit by the side of the road and you will not stop crying, Jesus, even though the majority tell you to shut up? Is there anybody here that's willing to go forward even when they tell you to shut up, when they tell you are too noisy, when they tell you are too holy? I'm going on, that's all I know. Excuse me, stay out of my lane. I'm advancing, I'm getting ready for a breakthrough, I'm getting ready for my miracle, I'm getting ready for my blessing. You can't stop me, you can't block me, you can't hinder me, you can't sabotage me. It's forward. Somebody show glory. Somebody show glory. Somebody show glory. Somebody show glory. Where are those that will declare by any means necessary, stand to your feet? Now talk to your neighbor. Say, neighbor, I don't care what anyone thinks. Tell him, I don't care what anyone says. I will go where no one else will go. I will go forward. I will do desperate things. Somebody show glory. Where are those of us that are ready to do desperate things? Tear the roof off if necessary. Is there anybody here that's willing to tear off the roof? If I gotta tear off the roof, if I gotta push through a crowd, if I gotta go down on my knees and walk, somebody say glory. Give your neighbor a handshake and say, neighbor, by any means necessary. By any means necessary. I don't care who's offended. Even the dogs will eat what's at the king's table. But if you call me a dog, I'm still going forward. If you try to push me down, I'm still going forward. Where are the advancers tonight? Where are the advancers tonight? Somebody open your mouth and shout advance. Somebody open your mouth and shout advance. One more time, open your mouth and shout advance. Somebody roll back your head and shout advance. Hey, oh, shout out and stand up. Come on, talk to your neighbor again. Talk to your neighbor again. I'm almost done. I have 5 more minutes. Woo! To neighbor, I'm willing to break barriers. To neighbor, I'm willing to climb a tree. Come on, change your neighbor. That neighbor don't believe you. Change your neighbor. I said, change your neighbor. Glory, 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 glory. A lot of Shanda, Keto, Shea, Tanda, Bahaya. Say, neighbor. Come on, talk to them. Say, neighbor. I'm willing to jump in a lake. Come on, talk to your neighbor. I do what I have to do. I say what I have to say. But by any means necessary, I'm getting my deliverance. By any means necessary, I'm getting my blessing. By any means necessary, I'm getting my joy. By any means necessary, I'm getting my breakthrough. If I have to climb on the chair, I'm getting my deliverance. Somebody show glory. By any means necessary, I'm gonna get my joy. By any means necessary, I'm gonna get my breakthrough. By any means necessary. Rabo Shanda Rabo Saya, by any means necessary. Somebody say yes. Somebody say yes. Somebody say yes. Somebody say yes. Somebody tell your neighbor, I'm desperate. Here is a problem. Some of us are too poised. I grew up here from I'm 19. Some of us are too stush. I'm looking at you, stush. Glory, glory, till cancer hit you. But this praise is a just-in-case praise. Glory to God. Is there anybody have a just-in-case praise? I don't have cancer, but just-in-case. I don't have diabetes, but just-in-case. I haven't gotten divorced, but just-in-case. Is there... Is there... Is there anybody here with a just in case break? Yes. 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 Just in case. Somebody said just in case. This praise is just in case. Somebody still too quiet. Somebody still looking at me. Somebody still don't have a praise. Everybody open your mouth. Get a just in case praise. Just in case. Just in case. I lose my mind. Just in case. I am a shackle tire. Come on, praise him. Come on, praise him. Come on, praise him. Come on, praise him. just in case. By any means necessary, just in case. Just in case. Somebody shout, I'm desperate. Somebody shout, I'm desperate. Somebody shout, I'm desperate. My time is finished. Hold on to your neighbor's hand. Come on, find a neighbor. If your neighbor too stush, find another one. Release. 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 Hey. Release. Release. Come on, hold on to your neighbor. Release, 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 release. Power, 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 power. Anointing, anointing, ketabo shanda. Anointing, anointing, ketabo. Hey! Hey! Yo, shanda, ketabo shanda. Come on, hold on to your neighbor. Don't let them go, don't let them go. There's a miracle in your connection. There's a healing in your connection. There's a deliverance in your connection. Tell your neighbor, just in case. Tell your neighbor, just in case. The devil tried to kill me, just in case. By any means necessary. By any means necessary. If I have to jump, I will jump. If I have to cross, I will cross. If I have to run, I will run. But by any means necessary, I'm getting my deliverance, and I'm getting it now. I'm getting my breath. Heko shakalabaha, rabanda moshaya, reko shakuta yabasanda. Come on, church. Come on, church. Rabo shakila bakoshanda. Just in case. Just in case. Just in case. Just in case. Just in case I get cancer. Just in case I get diabetes. Just in case the devil comes to my house, I gotta praise. I gotta praise. Anybody gotta praise? Anybody gotta praise? Just in case. Yeah, I am Oshanda. Echo Shanda na Bokaya. Come on, praise him. 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 I am Oshanda na Bokaya. Just in case. Just in case. Come on, come on. Come on, come on. Come on, church. Come on, church. Some people looking at me. You're looking at me like I'm crazy. But my enemy's necessary. Just in case. Just in case. Is there anybody here that can praise God? Just in case. You don't sure yet. It hasn't happened yet. Come on, church. Come on, church. I feel it in here. Hey, Shakura Boshanda. Hey, Yabo Shakura. Come on, praise him. Rabba Boshanda Nabahaya. Glory, glory, glory. Just in case. I got this praise. Just in case. I got this praise. Just in case.
praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him. What's gonna do? What's gonna do? What's gonna do? What's gonna do? Praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him.
I gotta pray.
I need to decide to shout glory. I need you to shout glory. I need to decide to shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Yeah. Together and give God praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Churches we have to recognize tonight. Amen. We have some churches we have to recognize tonight.
Yeah! Come on, come on, come on! One last praise, one last praise! Come on, put your hands together! All right, God bless
Amen.
You. Please be seated.
Amen. Can we say praise the Lord? I won't stop a Holy Ghost party if it's real. Because ain't no party like a Holy Ghost party. Because the Holy Ghost party don't stop. I said a Holy Ghost party don't stop.
Ain't no party like a Holy Ghost party, but the Holy Ghost party don't. Ain't no party like a Holy Ghost party, but the Holy Ghost party don't. Ain't no party like a Holy Ghost party, but the Holy Ghost party don't.
Shout out. Amen. Amen. We thank God for such a high time. Did our bishop preach on tonight? Mighty move of God. Amen. In regards to council business, we have a couple of churches. We have certificate of fellowship that our bishop will be receiving. Two churches. Let's give God a praise for two churches being added. See, we can worship, we can dance, we can pray, we can get healed, get the word, prophesy, speak in tongues, and handle business all in the same service, and it's still in order. Can we say amen? Let's give God a praise for these musicians tonight. The praise team, come on. God is good, but before we do that, amen, we want to offer an invitation. Perhaps someone here is not saved, filled with the Holy Ghost, baptized in Jesus' name. This is a good night. Every night's a good night, but tonight is a real good night to get your sins washed away or to give your life to Christ. The Bible says, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the what? Holy Ghost. How many here have the Holy Ghost tonight and you're glad about it? Everyone shout, Jesus saves. And we heard the word tonight to come out of our comfort zone. Some of us don't even realize that when Jesus came into the world, that was a new thing. God decided to do something new. Jesus is new. Wrapped himself up in flesh to become like us, to learn how to live like a man for 33 years, to teach us how to live like God. What a blessing. And so if there's one, we will receive you tonight. If you are not saved, if you don't have a church home, you don't know who Jesus is, and you want to be saved, filled with the Holy Ghost, baptized, now is your time. Now is your time. You can come from wherever you are. Amen. Let's give God praise on tonight for the word. So we're going to come down here with Bishop. And I know we have one of the pastors out of the two. Bishop, would you like to call them forth?
Yes. Praise the Lord, everyone. This is always an exciting time when we're able to receive into fellowship. Amen. Our brothers and sisters. From Montreal, we have Pastor Gregory Isaac, his wife and family. And if there's any members of the church, could you all come on down here, please? Pastor Gregory Isaac, his wife, his family, and if there's anybody from your church in Montreal, all of you come up here, please. Let's put them on this side, because this is a bigger side. Let's scoot a little bit over. Amen. Come on, put your hands together. Pastor Gregory Isaac, he's a mighty young man, a mighty man of God. We're excited to have him in the Canada District Council. Just go on over there, Pastor Isaac. Praise God. Go on over there and all your family and the members of your church. Amen. If you're here, amen, come on over. We love them. We love them. This New Testament Church of Jesus. New Testament Jesus name Apostolic Church in Lachine, Quebec. Amen. Come on, put your hands together for the Isaac family. We also have all the way from Outlook, Saskatchewan. Amen. Pastor Lois McQuinn and the Outlook Gospel Lighthouse in Outlook, Saskatchewan. Amen. She is not able to be here tonight. Amen. But she's joining us virtually. And she was in our board meetings, she was in our prayer meetings, she was in all of our sessions. She is Mi'kmaq, she is, amen, from the indigenous tribe over there in Outlook, Saskatchewan. So not only are we advancing in different territories, but we are advancing in different cultures. Amen. There's diversity in the Canada District Council, the 55th Episcopal District of the Pentecostal Assemblies of the World. Amen. And you know, I am so excited to welcome, amen, these two new pastors, amen, into our council. Amen. They are both evangelists by heart. Amen. They evangelize. Pastor McQuinn, amen, she is passionate for outreach and evangelism. She has a work beginning in New Brunswick, I've been a part of that, amen, Zoom session, and it's expanding, and very soon they'll have a building. Amen. And we praise God for what God is doing in Pastor McQueen's life. Thank you, Bishop. I want you to stand to your feet. I'm going to turn the mic over, amen, to our chairman and vice chairman. They'll read, amen, what this the welcome says, amen. And then we will anoint, amen, Pastor Isaac, amen, and his wife. And we will pray over them. And then we will officially receive them into fellowship. So I'm going to ask, amen, our suffragan bishops, amen, just to read, amen, what our plaque says.
I'm going to ask our vice chairman to do the honors of reading the certificates tonight.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, let's say praise the Lord again. Say it like you mean it, please.
Yeah, Lord.
Say it because you mean it.
Glory to God.
Amen. Praise the Lord Jesus. The Canada District Council, 55th Episcopal District of the Pentecostal Assemblies of the World, certificate of fellowship. This is to certify that the New Testament Jesus Name Apostolic Church in Akeen, Quebec, Pastor Gregory Isaac, is received into Christian fellowship with the Canada District Council of the Pentecostal Assemblies of the World tonight on Friday, October 14, 2022, signed by our diocesan, the Honorable Bishop Barrington E. Smith, and our church general secretary, Minister Kevin Newell. Let's receive them by a big hearty amen and praise the Lord. And I understand the other pastor is also watching tonight. So let's treat this like she's in the building. Canada District Council, 55th Episcopal District of the Pentecostal Assemblies of the World, certificate of fellowship. This is to certify that Outlook Gospel Lighthouse in Outlook, Saskatchewan, Pastor Lewis McQueen, is received into Christian fellowship with the Canada District Council of the Pentecostal Assemblies of the World tonight, Friday, October 14th, 2022. Again, signed by our Honorable Diocesan Bishop Barrington E. Smith and our General Secretary, Minister Kevin Newell. Let's say a hearty amen for them.
Jesus Christ, I anoint you, O God, for Christian fellowship.
The power of the Holy Ghost.
Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Be anointed.
Hey,
Father.
Let's raise your hand up there, Lord. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. We give you glory, God. We give you honor. We thank you for this, your son and your daughter. Lord God, you brought them into this ministry. Lord God, we thank you for them, for this church family. Oh God, we pray your anointing upon their ministry, upon their life. Oh God, I pray for increase. I pray, God, for expansion in your kingdom. Remember Pastor Lois McQueen. Remember the congregation in Outlook, Saskatchewan. I pray your anointing upon her right now, God, and upon her ministry. I pray you'll send forth a fresh dose of the Holy Ghost, oh God, upon them. In the mighty name of Jesus, we release your power and your glory, oh God, upon their ministry. We pray, Lord God, down, God, every yoke of bondage arise against them. We destroy Kanto Shatana Bahaya, every force of darkness. We speak divine deliverance, oh God, over their ministry. We declare the victory right now in the mighty name of Jesus. And Lord God, we welcome them and we give you glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' name.
We welcome you on the behalf of the Canada District Council as chairman and the constituents of this great council. We welcome you, your church, and the fellowship with us. May God bless you in Jesus' name, Pastor Gregory.
God bless you. Come on, God bless you. God God bless you. No, I'll be left out. God bless you. God bless you. Welcome to the 55th Episcopal District. Amen. I salute Pastor Lois McQueen. Amen. All the saints of Outlook. Amen. Gospel Lighthouse. Welcome. Amen. To the Canada District Council. Glory to God. Come on, our executive board members. Please come. Executive board, please come and welcome. Amen. Our members.
Follow me.
Oh,
anointing.
Oh, set me free. Let the power.
Let the power.
Let the power.
Oh, fall on me.
Hello, Shia. The anointing. Hey, God.
Put our hands together one more time. God bless you. We're going to, before we dismiss, we're going to ask if Sister Baker would come with our announcements for tomorrow. Isn't this a wonderful time we're having? Amen. Let's give God a praise for Sister Baker as she comes with our announcements. You don't want to miss what we have in store for you on tomorrow. Thank you.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise the Lord. We welcome you again to our Canada District Council, CDC, the 55th Episcopal of the Pentecostal Assemblies of the World. We are here for our 31st council session, and our diocesan is Bishop Barrington Smith and with his wife, First Lady Smith. Our chairman is Suffragan Bishop Hurst and with his wife, Lady Hurst. Amen. Our theme has been theme is advancing and expanding the kingdom of God. Here are our scheduled announcements for the next day. Registration is still open. Please, we're asking if you have not yet registered, please go to our online. Go online at canadapaw.ca, or you can register in person at our registration desk in the foyer. We also have limited copies of our CDC magazine still on sale. You can get a wonderful copy for $10. God bless you. Tomorrow morning, we are back here together at 8 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. for early morning prayer. District Elder Bolton Noah will be our facilitator, and it will be in the sanctuary and on Zoom. At 9 a.m. to 10 a.m., we are inviting everyone to our Christian education leaders. Please meet with your facilitator, Sister Eliever Baker, for the Christian Education Leaders Meeting. This will be in the Fellowship Hall. At 10 a.m. to 12 p.m., Youth in Action, they are hosting a breakfast with the diocesan. The cost is $5 a person, none other than with our own Bishop, Bishop Barrington Smith, and this will be in the Fellowship Hall. Please note that the brunch breakfast is open for everyone. Everyone. All ages, amen? They have 3 free spots to give away. So if you would like a spot, you are asked to see Sister Cheyenne, James, or Minister Craig Irish this evening for a possible free giveaway, amen? At 10:30 a.m. to 12 p.m. will be the Minister and Deacon's Wives discussion. The topic will be who you are, what you do, how it impacts the women advancing and expanding the kingdom. The speaker will be Missionary Michelle Richards. This will be in the Mississauga room and on Zoom. At 12 p.m. to 1:15, we will break for lunch. And even while that's happening, concurrently at 12:30 to 1:15, the minister and deacon's wives will be having their meeting. Again, in the Mississauga room and on Zoom. At 1:15 p.m. to 2:30 p.m. will be the preacher's council. And the topic will be sermon preparation. The speaker will be Suffragan Bishop Carlton Christie, and this will be in the Ottawa room and on Zoom. At 1:15 to 2:30, running concurrently, will also be Bible studies, and the topic will be advancing and expanding the kingdom of God. Our speaker will be Suffragan Bishop Hopeton Morris, and this will be in the Mississauga room and on Zoom. At 3 p.m. to 3:30 p.m., we'll be back for ushering his presence. Our speaker will be Brother Malik Mason, amen, and this will be in the sanctuary and on live stream. And at 3:30 will be our conclusion, our evangelistic service. We're coming back for a great time with our speaker, Minister Randy Reed, in the sanctuary and on live stream. We have a special announcement just at this time. We'd like to let everybody know, on October the 21st through to October the 22nd, we have the opportunity to join our CDC family in Ottawa as we celebrate the legacy of Dr. Nola Wilson. The homegoing celebration, Friday, October the 21st, there will be a viewing from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. and 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. The memorial service will be held at 7 p.m. at Calvary Church in Gloucester, Ontario. This is just outside of Ottawa. Saturday, October the 22nd, the viewing will be from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. and the homegoing service will be from at 10 a.m. and it will be again at Calvary Church. There are accommodation information. If you are interested, please see me and I can share that with you. But we also will have the opportunity in this service to celebrate the legacy of Dr. Edgar E.C. Wilson. Amen. He passed away earlier this year, at the end of last year. And unfortunately, due to COVID, we were unable to celebrate his legacy and his contribution to the Canada District Council. So we're asking every member who can make it, who's connected to the CDC, please make every effort to attend so we can celebrate the lives and legacy of these two wonderful people who were our founders of the Canada District Council. Amen? Amen. And I'm sure if you ever met either of them, you were touched by their lives in some way, some shape, or some form. If it wasn't for Sister Wilson singing Order My Steps, or Dr. Wilson, who was a part of the Cornerstone Academy of Biblical Studies, you were touched by their lives in some capacity. So we ask, please, if you can make every effort to attend, please do so. Let's come together as a united body to celebrate their lives. Amen? And our last and final announcement for this evening. Dinner is available after service this evening. God is so good because of the Holy Ghost party. Amen. I want everyone to say thank you, Jesus. Say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Dinner was $15, but it is now $10. So please, come on now. Come on now. You victory for him. Amen. Amen. So please support the Kennedy District Council. Please make, please, dinner will be served. I believe it's in the back. It's available in the back. So please, $10, please come and support. Amen. Support. Come on now. If you're hungry and you know it, say amen. 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 So please, please support us in Jesus' name. Now back to our chairman. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Let's put our hands together for Sister Baker. Amen. And all they have. So we're still a busy council. It's good to see Elder Reginald Williams on tonight from New York. God bless you, Elder Williams, and all of the constituents and those of you that have come from near and far to be with us. Also, I want to give everyone a reminder, we have vendors out there. Clap your hands for the vendors. I want to thank everyone that we made the announcement last night and you went out and you supported. So I'm asking those of you to go out and support our vendors on the way out. See what products they have, sow a seed or buy something and encourage them because we thank God that we're able to have our own. As Forrest stated, we are starting a business guild for the Canada District Council. For those of you that have a business and you want to be equipped with knowledge of how to grow your business and be a part of a conclave of other entrepreneurs so that we can get you information and help your business grow, then you need to contact our general secretary so we can get your name and information so we can get you involved and so that the Canada District Council can get acquainted with your business. Let's clap our hands for all the business owners in our council. All right, so we thank God. Please support Kingdom Life Ministries. They are selling dinners on tonight. We know that they are laboring and serving us. Let's clap our hands for Kingdom Life. Amen. And so let's remember that the cooks and they're laboring, and so they don't want to see the food just standing there and everyone leaves out and goes somewhere else. I'm asking everyone, if you don't mind, that you would go back to the rear and purchase the dinners that they have for us because we want to support the hosting church. And so at this time, we're going to ask if everyone will stand, and we're going to ask for our senior statesman, the Honorable Suffragan Bishop, amen, Tulloch, to come. Let's clap our hands as he comes to give us our benediction.
God bless you, sir. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Bishop. Praise the Lord. Let's all bow our heads. Praise the Lord. Wasn't it an awesome night tonight? Praise the Lord. We thank God. Amen. Let's bow our heads. Father, we thank you for your loving kindness. We thank you for such an anointing, oh God, in the house tonight. And we thank you, oh God, that you make our hearts glad. And we pray now, Father, as we're about to go, that you'll go with us. Cover us, Lord Jesus, on the highways and byways. Jesus, be our guide and shelter us and keep us safe. Bless every home, bless everyone, bless every car, bless all means of transportation that your people will take tonight and guide your people home. I give you thanks. I praise you. I bless your name in Jesus' name. Peace be unto you all in Jesus' name.